How do you pick the best productivity applications? It's a tricky thing. Today, I'm going to show you three frameworks that might suit you in terms of choosing the ones that are right for you as a foundation to your productivity tools. Now, remember before we begin, if you already have tools that work for you or a workflow that suits you, there's no need to update and choose a different tool. If it works for you, keep with it. Today, we're lucky to have Miro as our whiteboard partner with Keep Productive. We'll be using it to visualize everything in today's video. If you like it, you can check it out in the link in the description. And if you don't know what it is, Miro is a collaborative whiteboard for Teams. You can check it out below. So let's look at this. We've got three core types of working and we call them classic, hybrid, and all-in-one. So let's start with classic. Classic is something that originated from the 1990s book, David Allen's book, Getting Things Done. And what it essentially did was kickstart the productivity tool movement in helping people to choose three core apps: a notes app, a tasks app, and a calendar app. And naturally, that's been probably something that's lasted about 15 years until more recently when people have expanded out. The main reason behind that is because software only tended to do one job very well in terms of having a great notes app, having a great calendar app, and having a great to-do list app. And we're still seeing that today, and a lot of people still go off this methodology. I do myself. I just pick sort of something that tends to work with notes, tasks, and calendar. But it's a good framework to have because if you're getting started with productivity, having those three core sort of trinity of applications can be a great way for you to start getting things done. And having those separation between them means that you won't have any cross-contamination between certain things. And it gives a place for things to live. And it's a great starting point if you're new to productivity application. But there has been an evolution in this in the last couple of years, and this is definitely more for the technophiles out there that are more interested in productivity applications, but that brings in hybrid. Now, hybrid is like having two tools. What it does is it takes one tool and does it well, but it takes another tool and combines the use. So for example, you might have a calendar and a task app in one. And what it'll probably do is it'll probably do that 80 to 90% well, not necessarily as good as having a dedicated application for that, but it saves you potentially some money and potentially some effort interacting with three applications, you'll be interacting with two. So essentially hybrid is becoming much more popular. We're seeing calendar tasks, calendar notes apps, notes tasks apps. They're sort of weaving two experiences into one, like a dual application. Maybe I should call it dual application instead of hybrid application, and then having an additional application on the side. This is becoming very common. For example, many people are going that calendar and tasks groups and having a notes app on the side. And we'll do a video that sort of dives a bit more into how and whether this might be suitable for you. So make sure you subscribe in this video. And then there's a final category, the all-in-one. Now, all-in-one productivity applications have been talked about for many years. A lot of people actually saying there's not one tool to rule them all, but there actually has been a very big leap in what people define as all-in-one. Applications like Coda, Airtable, and Notion have been primarily dominating the space as all-in-one productivity application. And a lot of people are happy with that because they do 80 or 70 to 80% of the job very well. So someone might use Notion for calendar, notes, and tasks in one place and be pretty happy with it. So we're starting to see that become a lot more popular. And that really is best for the person that is more into these tools, but is willing to sacrifice quality of the experience and a bit more customization and a bit more sort of initial learning curve to actually building these sort of setups that might be suitable for you. So moving on to a few questions, a lot of people tend to ask, okay, I like, say, the concept of the classic traditional setup of three tools. I'm using another tool for work and I want to be able to manage projects. This is actually something that I personally had an experience with when I moved from being a student to doing freelance or running or starting a company. It's difficult because you want to have that separation between the things. I tried it for a long time with just a task app and I used the filtering system behind it, and I found it quite stressful because I was like, I've got all my to-do-ist tasks here, and I was like, oh, it's overwhelming. But actually having a separate application for your projects can be quite helpful. So that might be something you want to add on to your experience, is a project application, because it gives you that separation between work and personal tasks. But that's really a decision that's just for you in terms of looking what is best for you. Another thing is foundations. Typically, when people try and find productivity applications, they assume that everything is on the productivity app. If it's not the productivity app solving it, it's definitely that software's fault. And it might be actually your fault. It might be the way that you tend to best work that might be the issue. So for example, if you're somebody that chooses Task app, a calendar app, and a notes app, and you're somebody that is not so good on the old, you're better on the old calendar, then a hybrid system with tasks and calendar might be better for you. Being able to visualize your time using time blocking techniques might be better for you. So it's actually working out how you work before you work out what you work with is probably the best solution. It's like a house, build good foundations, and then obviously everything on top of it will work well once you've built that groundwork. And also looking at how you've learned productivity can be really, really helpful. Now, obviously there are a few additional questions of how do you find tools? How do you find all of these applications? Well, I think a lot of it is primarily research and making sure you learn from your past experiences and you do some research that matches the needs of your current and long-term situation. The one thing I recommend is to look at yourself in the next 3 to 5 years and say, am I going to adapt or change my system in the next 3 or 5 years? Am I expecting to retire? Am I expecting to have a child? Am I expecting to go back to studying? And being able to map the tool to fit, hopefully, that scenario in the long term. It means you'll stay with the productivity app longer and you'll grow with the productivity app, which is really, really important. Once you've found one, optimize it. Really learn how other people have used it. Set and forget. Set things up and then hopefully it will run like a dream in the background. Instead of necessarily tinkering every single week, put that time into optimizing it first and refining it versus necessarily spending too much time on the actual productivity tool, which can be detrimental in the long term. Finally, do we all need productivity tools? This is a great question that I tend to get because we cover so many tools here on the channel. We don't. We don't necessarily need productivity tools. My friends, my wife, they don't use productivity tools and they're probably a lot more efficient than I am. A lot of people find that. Some people don't need tools. And some people need, you know, systems typically tend to work better than necessarily tools. And it's important to be able to understand that. You know, like we had pretty famous people back in the past. Benjamin Franklin used a journal and that was a productivity tool of his time, but he was able to get quite a lot done in that time period. So obviously we're in a very luxurious time where we can add these beautiful tools, but they aren't necessarily the solution to our productivity. The way we think, the way we build our groundwork is better than the tool we layer on top. Just something that I've noticed from years of reviewing tools and applications. Some of the best people don't use any of them. A good example is I worked with managing director of a company in the past and watching him not use any tools, I learned a lot about how it doesn't really matter about the tools so much. He was able to keep an eye on a lot of stuff without getting too stressed and be able to sort of holistically plan without any of these tools in place. And it was impressive to see, as well as keeping calm and collected throughout the experience, teaching me a lot of lessons that how tools don't matter as much, you know, to every single day managing your productivity. But they also, if you do find value in them, they can be hugely beneficial. Interesting story, at least. I hope you found this video useful, folks. If you haven't yet checked out Mira, it'll be linked in the description. They're our whiteboard partner here on Keep Productive. But I hope you found some useful advice from how to choose the best productivity app. If you're new here, hit subscribe and I'll talk to you all very soon. It's been great chatting. See you later, folks. Bye.